There are new health concerns tonight about tampons. So here to talk about that, Dr. Todd Ellerin, who is the deputy chair of medicine at South Shore Health. So more than half, doctor, of Americans who menstruate, they use tampons. So why are researchers, and this is from the University of California, correct, at Berkeley, why are they now asking, are these safe to use? That's concerning. Why is this question
right.
coming up
what
now?
What the researchers found, and this was seminal, is the first time that they actually measured metal concentrations within tampons, and that includes things like lead and arsenic. And what they found is in tampons, whether they were organic or inorganic, whether they were from the United States or the EU or the UK, what they were seeing was detectable levels of metals. And so that's something that we have to learn more about.
Do you think the government should get involved?
I think what's important is, you know, the FDA does regulate these products, okay?
Right.
So I think what's important is that the regulators and then the tampon manufacturers have to do more testing so we can figure this out.
But and why now?
Well, the other thing is I want people to realize we did not, the researchers did not look at levels in the circulation in our body, so systemic. They measured it within the tampons.
Oh.
So the question really is, are there levels that are leaching out of the tampons being absorbed through the vagina into the circulation? And then is that causing any real problems? We don't know that yet. So I don't want people to panic. You know, these were low levels, but we have to figure out what it means.
And very low levels. Remember when we were dealing with toxic shock syndrome back in the day? And that there was a particular brand of tampon. I remember doing the story. I remember.
That's right.
That was a huge concern. This is not that.
That is not. That was a toxic bacteria. These are metals that, frankly, you know, we don't really want to think about that there's lead in our tampons, but they are low levels. We are, as a population, exposed to low levels of metals.
Right.
And we just want to make sure, though, this is a hypothesis-generating study. We don't want it to end here, and we want the manufacturers and the regulators to collaborate so we can have answers and say, you know what, these are low levels, but they're safe, or they're not.
What do you tell the women in your life?
Well, right now, I am not saying that you have to abandon tampons. Tampons are so important. Like you said, more than 50% of people who are menstruating use tampons. But if you're worried about it, remember there are alternatives, whether they're pads, cups, whether they're, period underwear. There are other, alternatives. But tampons are used very commonly. And remember, these have been around since 1931, Maria.
Right.
So people aren't running into my office or into the hospital with heavy metal poisoning.
But this is something that you're going to continue to keep an eye on.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Dr. Todd Ellerin, we appreciate it. Thank you.